If you're just joining, I'm just doing a bit of wood engraving, just printing the third layer of a reduction print. And I've got a lot to do, so I thought I might as well go live while I do it. So I started this print back, I think it was October I started it, and I did the first layer in, I think, November, and then second layer in January. And when I got back from a bit of time away in February, I decided I didn't like it anymore, and only today have I continued with it. So this is layer three. It's a bit patchy, so I'm just going to add a bit more pressure. So that's it with three layers. So there will be, I think, two more layers. But I was going to do like a brighter green, but I feel like my style's changed even since the autumn. So yeah, I've gone with like a more muted tone, which I think works well. Just need to add it to the others that I've already printed. I don't have space to hang up artwork in my studio, so yeah, I've stacked it up. I'll take it into the house later for it to dry. It's also not particularly warm in here, so it's better to take it into the shed. So yeah, it's quite a repetitive process, but you have to concentrate because otherwise a print can go wrong and then you lose one in the edition. So yeah, that's what it looks like before you add the third layer. So I didn't really like the yellow ochre colour along the bottom, but it works because this green covers it, but also allows it to be a bit of a warmer tone at the bottom as the yellow ochre comes through a little bit. So it does work. But yeah, I was just a bit stuck with it until today. Oh, thank you. That's very kind. So yeah, it's the press does most of the work, but it won't print the middle of the image because it's quite a small press. So yeah, I finish it off with the bone folder here. And the plaster on my thumb is that I hurt my thumb making this block yesterday. Not with my engraving tools. Everyone always thinks that I must slip a lot with the tools, but I don't. I hurt it on the actual wood itself, and it's really sore today, hence the plaster. I was meant to be filming some videos today, and now I can't because, I mean, it doesn't look great. Hoping it will be better by tomorrow. So yeah, I peel it back each time just to make sure I've got all the bits I need to. It's not too bad to print this one because it's not a huge area. When I printed the whole block, that was really hard, but just it's only the bottom third really now, and it's easier to print, which is a bit of a relief. So I'm just putting sheets of glassine paper over the top of the print so that they don't you know, transfer ink to each other. So I just add a little bit more ink to the roller each time. This roller's only just wide enough to ink the whole thing, but I didn't want to get the size up because I didn't want to, it kind of wastes ink if you have a roller that's a bit too big. Oh, hi, Lulabelle. Yeah, so it's just about big enough. There's also like a slight split in the wood there, but it doesn't seem to be a problem too much when it's printed, so that's good. It's because it's two bits of lemon wood stuck together, so sometimes where it's joined it splits, especially if it gets warm. So in all my videos, I think it looks quite effortless, like the printing press part of it, in my YouTube shorts, because I don't put in the bit where I spend ages burnishing it with a bone folder, just because it would be boring. But yeah, this is the reality, and you don't want to slip and go off where the design is printing, because always it will damage the paper. I think if I had like a much bigger press, I wouldn't have to do this, but the press is small. So yeah, it's turned out so far better than I thought it would. So I think it's going to be called mackerel sky, which is a name for when the sky has like kind of mackerel like markings in it. And this tree is one I walk past most days when I go on a dog walk. What shade of green am I using? I'll show you. I've mixed it. I always mix my colours. I never use direct from the tube unless it's black. So I mixed yellow ochre, white, and then was it processed blue or Prussian blue? I think it was Prussian blue. Yeah, because it looks, it's got a green tinge to it. So yeah, I mixed that, but it's mainly white. I'm using dry paper. Yeah, I don't wet it, it's very thin. I don't think it would cope with adding moisture to it, but it's coated in calcium carbonate to help the ink kind of take to the paper, which helps. Thank you. That is early or late, depending on how you look at it. But I hope I help you get to sleep. I have a quite bad insomnia, so I'm often watching videos in the middle of the night to try and help me to sleep. Yeah, I was meant to be filming a video today like this, where I print this print in different colours, but as I said, my thumb has a plaster on it, so I'm not going to make a video today, but I'm planning to do it, maybe, I don't know how long it would be, like half an hour to an hour long video where I'm just printing this print and hoping it might help people relax or get to sleep. I won't be talking, I don't think. I was thinking of adding like, I'm going to the beach soon and adding like the sound of the beach over it, because I just think it might be a bit weird if it's just kind of silent apart from like the tools and things I'm using. Anyway, yeah, I was hoping to do that today, but maybe I'll do it tomorrow. I just thought it'd be good to have a playlist that's like extra relaxing for people to watch when they can't sleep or they're stressed or whatever. You can see there, can you see? I like went past the tree and you can see it's slightly dented the paper, so that's, you just got to be careful not to do that. Oh, I'm glad, Janet. what lino cut you're doing, what is the subject matter. I love watching people on lives when I work. I can't work in silence. I tend to watch lives of people packing orders and things. I don't actually tend to watch art videos to relax just because it reminds me too much of work and makes me think about work. I prefer to watch other things. So yeah, I'm thinking I'll add a mid green and then maybe like a greeny navy to finish at some point. But this will need to dry, so I'll wait at least 2 weeks before I print the next layer. It's quite a long process, and it's been made longer by the fact that I delayed continuing with it for ages. But yeah, hopefully this will be finished by May maybe or June. Oh, a cluster of beech trees, that's nice. Yeah, I love doing trees. This one, I engraved this tree yesterday, so obviously it was already on the block and I cut around it. It was so much work moving the background, that's why I hurt my thumb. And yeah, I'd really enjoyed adding the marks between the branches so you could see the sky coming through. I didn't think it was going to look as effective as it does. I was kind of just going for it, but yeah, it was satisfying. No, I've only ever used Cranfield inks really, just because they're made quite local to me. I visited the factory a couple of years ago. They gave me a tour. Yeah, so I've just really used those because they're made in Wales, and I think it's like just around an hour's drive from here. So it feels nice to be using like a local product. And they're really lovely there, so. So I'm meant to be uploading a new YouTube video this week about paper making. I filmed it with my friend Catherine over 2 weeks ago now, but I haven't had the energy to edit it. And also I ran out of space on my computer. So I was trying to edit the podcast that I do on Saturday. I couldn't even save it because I'd run out of memory, so I need to sort that out before I edit this week's video. But I'm hoping it will still be out normal time, Wednesday at 8 p.m. UK time. But yeah, we'll see. Oh, hi. I'm just printing. If you've just started watching, I'm just printing the third layer on this wood engraving. I'm always surprised that it keeps printing quite well. So yeah, this is an old oak tree near where I live, and it split in half about a year and a bit ago. This side of the tree just completely fell. So I kind of wanted to immortalise it as it was. Although it's still doing really well. I walked past it this morning and it's all its spring leaves out. But yeah, it was so symmetrical and such a lovely tree. So yeah, I wanted to create a print of it as it was before it fell in half. So yeah, this week's video is going to be about paper making, I think. I mean, I haven't looked at the footage yet. I keep thinking it will be terrible. But if it's not terrible, it will be about paper making. And then yeah, the one after will be a video of me printing on the paper. It kind of depends how long. So if I'm doing a reduction print, like this, but in a day. So I'm working outside and I do it all in a day. I can just about get 5 layers down in one day, but the ink will be really wet, and it's not great. It doesn't print as well. If I'm doing this in the studio, I tend to leave 1 to 2 weeks between layers. And it depends. I find if you've put it in like a warm, dry place for the first 24 hours, it dries a lot better than if it was, like, say I left it in here, which is basically a shed, for the first 24 hours. It would just be way slower to dry, even if you then took it into a warm place. But yeah, 1 to 2 weeks before adding another layer, ideally. But if you're just doing a one colour print, that can dry quite quickly. It's when you start to layer up different, if there's 2 or more layers of ink, the subsequent layers tend to take ages to dry. I guess because it kind of soaks into the paper a little bit on the first layer, whereas, yeah, it doesn't print dry so well from then on. But it's okay because it gives me time to work on other things. I love Scotland. I'm glad I'm here to distract you. What are you printing today? I haven't been to, when did I last go to Scotland? 2021, I think. Yeah, I'd love to go again. So I can see this print hasn't aligned very well. So it might be one that doesn't make the edition. We'll see. Can you see there's like a tiny bit of yellow ochre? Don't know how clear that is for you. There's a tiny strip of yellow ochre along the bottom. So it's like 1 mil misaligned. You can't really tell. I'll see how it goes with the other layers. But, yeah, you got to watch out for that with production printing. Oh, really? 2 weeks? Yeah, it really does depend. At this time of year, you know, when it's, if you're in a place that isn't particularly warm. But I'm in, my studio's in the attic, and not this studio, my main studio. This is just where I print and do picture framing. And it gets quite warm because it's got 2 Velux windows, and then obviously all the heat rises in the house. So even in like the middle of winter, it's quite a warm room. So things don't take that long to dry. You can add in things into your ink to make them dry quicker. I've got up here magnesium dryer. If you add that in, it's meant to make it dry quicker, but I've never really noticed that much of a difference. But it's like you need a tiny, tiny amount. I think if you add too much, it has like the opposite effect and it doesn't dry. So I kind of stay away from that. The only thing where it's annoying when something doesn't dry is because I run out of drying space, because I've got like clothes pegs like that. All the way up my stairs and then along the ceiling, and it is like a limited amount of space I have, so I can't work on more than 2 medium editions at a time, I'd say. I think I can hang like 120 prints at one time. I need to replace this on the press. It's like a makeshift thing to hold. I think it's holding the handle on, but I need to get it restored. I did it again there, can you see? I keep going past tree. I mean, I don't think it would be that obvious. We'll have a look from the front, but it's really easy to do because I can't actually see where the tree is under there. I mean, I can feel it, but yeah, it's very easy to slip off. Bit patchy. I think we need to add more ink for the next print. Also, if the previous layer is patchy, which this one is a bit, it means the next layer is more likely to be patchy because there's like the bits where it didn't print last time, the ink kind of doesn't sit as well, but I think it'll be okay by the end. They're not perfect because they're hand printed, so you've got to kind of accept that. I mean, yeah, it's part of the fact that they're all unique because they're all hand printed. So I'm just adding a bit more ink to the roller. I'm trying to keep the camera steady, but it is attached to me, so it's not actually that steady. That looks like a better amount of ink to me. So yeah, that's the block. It's a bit of a different print to what I normally do because, I mean, the sky is so vast on it. Like, just two layers on the sky, and then I'm only working on this bottom section now. It's quite nice to do something different there. But these prints are nice and dry because I printed these around the 24th of January or something like that, before I went on my residency in North Wales. So they're really dry prints, which is nice because they're just easier to print on. If your print isn't dry, when you print the next layer, like some of the ink that was already on the paper tends to come off onto the block and it just isn't as nice a print. Yeah, that printed nicer, I think. Yeah, because it had just that bit much more ink on it. Yeah, it's quite a big print for me, this one, compared to my, that's a hand print, quite big, compared to my normal work, which is normally like tiny. So yeah, it's nice to work on like a range of sizes, especially as if I only have small prints at shows, it's really hard to fill the space, and I've got a couple of shows coming up. Ah, there's a place in Bridgewater, in the UK called Bridgewater, and it's where I adopted my dog from, where we went to pick her up from. I didn't know there was another one. Thank you. Yeah, I think that needs a little bit more ink. Probably gonna have to mix up a bit more ink because it's taking quite a lot to cover this. I've got such a huge stack of prints still to do, but it's worth it. Like, it does feel like quite hard work when you print a lot of prints at once, but it's worth it. If it's a popular print, it's worth having a nice amount of them. But then sometimes I find I print loads of prints and then something's not popular. And then the thing that is popular, I hardly have anything of. So it's really hard to second guess. Oh, hi. I feel like it's very international, everyone watching. Like the green's getting brighter as I print. I don't think it is, but it just looks like it is. Actually, it might be because the background's a bit brighter, because I'm famously not very good at consistent printing. Like, I might have changed the colour of the sky halfway. I can't really remember because it was so long ago that I printed it. Thank you. Yeah, honestly, when I got back from the residency I was on in January and February, and then I saw this print, this one, hanging up all over my studio, I was like, that is just the worst thing I've ever seen. I just completely fell out of love with it. And I just thought, I've already done two layers. I've done so many of the prints. I don't want to waste it, but also that is not something I want to continue with. It was only yesterday that I was like, I'm going to keep going. I'm glad I did, because I do think the third layer has pulled it together. But yeah, I'd lost all faith in it. It's got a mark on it there. Is that a mark? Yeah, we just have to hope that's covered up by the green. Oh dear, can you see there where I've gone like over the ground into the bit I've taken away? I'll have a look from the front and see how that looks. It's so easily done when you can't see what you're doing. It's not too obvious. You can see a bit of like a dink in the paper there. So if I just use my nail on the back, that should help make it less obvious. But yeah, it's always a risk when you're hand burnishing. I was saying earlier, I don't have space to hang work in here, so that's why I'm stacking up like that with a glass scene paper between, stop them from sticking to each other. Every time I pick up a new print, I think, oh my god, I have so many to do. That is like a stack of how many I'm doing. And then I've got a stack of like print proofs as well. But I'll print just, they've already gone wrong basically, but I'll print them just to use as collage material later on. I was doing collaging last night actually. The art foundation course that I went on when I was like 18 has, well, it's closing down, and we're all making bits of art to kind of put on a show, and I realized the deadline to send it off was today, so I was doing it last night. And I was collaging and thinking, I really am lacking collage material at the moment because I've done so much collage and not actually very much printing, especially I haven't done like any larger, this is large for me, prints recently. So yeah, hopefully this will help add some more material to my stash. In fact, it will help because I've got so many that have gone wrong from this already. I think I printed like 120 and I've probably only got 70 because it's a bit of a long story, but I used pencil on the block to kind of sketch it out, and it transferred to a lot of the prints, which isn't normally a problem because the ink covered it up, but it transferred to quite a lot of the sky area that wasn't being covered up. So I have to discard loads, like a huge stash of them. It's very annoying, but you know, I'd rather discard them than release prints that aren't very good. So if you have any questions, do pop them in the chat. I'm not always very good at getting back to messages because they can build up. But yeah, while I'm here, do ask me anything. It's helping time go faster doing this on a live than doing it just here on my own. Sunshine's coming in now, which is nice. It was hailing this morning, so it's a nice change. So the paper I use is Zirkle, and it's a special wood engraving paper, but Zirkle stopped making paper. They closed their factory maybe 2 years ago now, 18 months ago, I think. So I bought up a load before they closed because, yeah, I just didn't have an alternative. But I think there is an alternative now. Is it on Jackson's Art, maybe? If you Google Zirkle wood engraving doppelganger or something like that, Zirkle wood engraving alternative, I think it will come up, but I haven't tried the replica one, basically the one that they've made to kind of mimic it. I think it's good though. I think people are using it. It's very the paper I use is very smooth and quite thin, and yeah, it's coated in calcium carbonate, so it's quite specific. If it had texture to it, it just would be really hard to print. Oh, thank you, Estelle. Yeah, the sky was really fun to do, although it was like quite hard to know how to replicate like a mackerel sky effect with the ink, like on the block. Oh, I keep wanting to make a video. That's Pookie Press versus Albion Press. So I do most of my printing on the Albion Press. My Pookie Press is down there. Any tips? Well, I use it for wood engraving, but I think if you use it for lino, you might want to use the blanket that you can get with it. I don't know if it comes with it. I have one somewhere. But I don't use that for wood engraving. Tips. I don't know, I find it really like good because it's portable. So when I'm out and about printing, it's great because it helps get the majority of the block printed. Much like this, so the Albion gets like the outside of the design printed, but doesn't quite have enough pressure to print the center, so I always take a bone folder with me when I print outside on the Pookie Press, just to burnish the middle of the print like I do when I'm printing here. But yeah, depending on what you're printing on it, I don't think I have any tips, but it's all really trial and error, I guess. But yeah, I want to do a video where I compare it, because it's obviously like, if I had the Albion and the Pookie Press as options to me, like I do now, I'll always choose the Albion because I find it a bit easier to use and the pressure's better. But I can't take this Albion out with me, so I'm so pleased to have the Pookie Press when I'm out and about. I take it to shows and I print at shows, which is fun. Also, this is like, this press is like 10 times the price of the Pookie Press, so it's like a really good affordable alternative. Yeah, so there's going to be two more layers, I think, after this one. I'll just show you. Needs a bit more burnishing. Yeah, so this was going to have like brighter, warmer colours, this print, but when I went to the Malbach residency in North Wales, after I'd printed the second layer of this print, I really loved using like similar colours in one print. So instead of using like bright, warm colours as I was planning, I've made like a muted green. And then I'll probably do a slightly darker green, which is a bit more on the blue side. And then I'll probably do like almost a navy for the last layer. So yeah, two more layers. I want to keep it like blue and green rather than trying to fit in all the colours that I possibly can, which was my original plan. but I just don't know if it really would have worked that well. Hang on. Is there anywhere else to get wood blocks? Yeah, I think Chris is swamped with orders as well. There, if you go on any of the printmaking sites, like Jackson's, Lawrence, they, I think, have wood blocks, and you can just buy them, like, they're already made, I think. I don't think they're custom sizes, though. But the blocks that I've had that aren't made by Chris Daunt are quite shiny. Like, they're almost over-polished or sanded, and I tended to slip quite a lot when I was engraving them. And also, I found the boxwood really hard. I don't know, I just wasn't that keen on them compared. So, have you ordered from him? Like, have you got an order placed, but he's just taken a while? Because it does take at least a month, I'd say, to get an order from Chris, depending on what time of year, because he has, because he's making his own art and all the blocks, I think, although he does have help with making the blocks, but yeah, busy periods, you're going to be waiting a good few weeks, I think. So I use lemon wood, boxwood, and holly and maple. The sheep block that I just did, that was maple, I think, but I don't really like working on maple, to be honest. I don't use blocks like I've prepared from local wood, because I just don't have the skill. I don't know anyone that would be able to get them smooth. Oh no. So I've dented this one, so this is not going to make the addition, because that will always be obvious, unfortunately. What were you saying? Oh, cherry and plum apple. So how long did you season them for? Because I think it's normally like 2 to 3 years. Otherwise, they could spill it, I think. I'm not sure. I just think, because it takes so long to engrave things, I want the wood to be stable and flat, and like, don't want to finish engraving something and then realise the wood isn't going to work. So yeah, this is printed fine, but this is not ideal. So that will go not in with that stack. Oh, I don't want to blind you all with this light. So just been hanging the ones that go wrong up here. Or they're like proofs. But yeah, I need to place an order actually for some more wood blocks. It is on my to-do list this week. But yeah, you've got to make sure you do it in advance of when you need them, just because he's so busy. So I was saying earlier, not my next video, but the one after is going to be printing this in real time, but it's going to be multicoloured on the handmade paper that is going to be in the video this week. So if I do a video, so it'd be like what I'm doing now, but with no talking, I think. So if you're watching that, would you want some, like, a sound of the ocean over the top of it? along with like the sound of the press and stuff, or would you just like the sound of the press? Because I feel like it could, I worry it'll be a bit awkward if it's just me printing silently. Did I already print that? I can't remember. I'll do it again if not. But yeah, I'm going to the beach this week, so I thought I can always just record some sounds, but I didn't know if it would be annoying. You love the sound of the press. It is a nice sound. So it would have the sound of the press, but it would also have over the top sound of like the ocean and yeah, I just don't know. Ocean sounds lovely. Okay. I'll have a think. I just want it to be a really, I want it to be like an hour long video of me printing where you can just put it on if you can't sleep, that kind of video. I thought I could make a playlist of like relaxing videos. Because I watch, I think he's called Connor Does Coffee. I don't even drink coffee, but he has like hour long videos of him making coffee in a coffee shop. So he's just taking orders. But there's quite a lot of like coffee shop noise there, so it's not like awkwardly quiet. So normally when I'm working, I'm listening to true crime podcasts, so that is not an option. But I was gonna add the sound of the ocean like after. So I'd be working in silence, which could be a bit of a challenge for me, to be honest. And then I'd add the sounds of the ocean in after. When I was testing it on Saturday, I was testing this camera that I'm wearing now, but in landscape mode for the video. And I just didn't want it to be too like much of a jolt when I was printing, which I think it is, but I can't really do anything about it. But I was watching back the footage and I didn't realize that I was like humming and singing. I didn't even know I was doing it, so I need to somehow stop myself doing that. But yeah, no, normally I'm like watching something or listening to something when I work. I get really bored. You can see it's quite a repetitive process, these larger editions. So yeah, I tend to listen to podcasts and things. Or do it in a couple of sessions. Like last time, what was I putting? Oh, the sheet block that I just released. I got such a sore hand printing that I started to get like I don't know if it was ligament pain or something, like weird shooting pains up my wrists, so I had to stop and go do another session. So sometimes even if I carry on, my body is like, no, this is too much, and then I have to stop. But that sheet block was really hard to print because it needed enough ink because it was quite a big block, but too much ink, and it was quite a delicate design, so it flooded. It was really frustrating. How did I manage to? Oh, maybe I've got ink on my plaster. Oh dear. Managed to get ink on the side of that. How many more have I got left to print today? I don't know, maybe 50, by the looks of the pile. But I might not do them all today. I might do them tomorrow. Quite a lot. I think that's Maybe that's 40. As I said, there are a lot more, but I've discarded them already from the edition. Poor prints are not gonna make it. So these were all discarded because, well, I've written proof, so something went wrong. I don't know what, but if something goes wrong, I have to write proof, otherwise I print it regardless and don't know what's gone on. And here, where the pencil mark transfers, it's not a problem because normally I print over it, but this bit here is a problem. So many have been discarded. There's another maybe 40 upstairs also discarded. I didn't even bother to bring down. Basically, it's not ideal. But it does make my printing sessions shorter, so, you know, there's a silver lining. Thank you. It is a nice process. It's, yeah, it takes a while to kind of work out, and I still make mistakes, as you just saw. But, it is a nice process, and also it's so, like, it can go wrong so easily. Definitely keeps you on your toes. So with an edition size, so if it's just a one color print, I tend to do around 50 on average. If it's a print that's I think will be popular, I might do 100. But if it's a block that is hard to print, I will do less just because it would drive me mad. So I if it's a tricky block, like the sheep print, I think I did 40. I was really aiming for 50, but I just thought I can't do anymore. And then if it's a reduction print like this one, say I wanted 75 at the end, like that was my goal, to have an edition of 75. Because I thought it was going to be quite popular. I might print 100, 110 and expect to lose some, depending on how tricky the design is. So you always want to print more at the beginning than you think you'll want at the end. So I printed about 120, I think, of this. But I think I'll get an edition of 50 or 60, but that's because I messed up with the pencil marks. And that was just like a rookie error. So, yeah. You don't always have control of how many you actually have in the edition if you're doing reduction prints. And if you're as fussy as me about what makes the edition. I was just thinking, you placed it in March. Oh, if you place it in March and it's midway through April, it should come this month. But yeah, he's really busy. He needs to train up a team. But the I visited Chris's house last year. His workroom for making blocks is in his house, so it's not so easy to employ people, I don't think. But yeah, no, I'd say if I ordered from Chris, and and I hadn't received my blocks after 6 weeks, I'd email him. Yeah. How many did you order? What did you order? Have you ordered from him before? Oh, so I don't tend to make new additions. So if it's a reduction print, I can't because the block's destroyed in the process. So like with this block, I'll just be left with a very small amount of like this original surface left. So I couldn't redo it. With my other blocks, I won't reprint an addition. I think occasionally I've reprinted in different colours. But if I do that, I'd like to try and know I'm doing that before I release the first lot so that my customers know there will be another edition separate but with the same blocks. But with this print, so I've used all these blocks before in different, apart from this one actually, that has never been printed before. But so it's like the same blocks, but like completely different composition. So I would reuse them in that sense, but I wouldn't. So the sheet block I just finished, if that sold out, I think there's like 4 left. I won't reprint that. Also, as you can see, it is quite repetitive. So I like working on new blocks because then you get, you know, like at the moment when I pull the print back, it's still quite exciting because it's like a new block to me. I don't like getting to the stage where I'm like bored with a design. So I'll probably go in a minute because I need to take the prints I've done. I'll go after I've printed this one, and take them inside, hang them up, and then come back out and do more. But yeah, I'll go after this because I've been live for 58 minutes, which has flown by, so thanks for keeping me company. But I'll just finish printing this. I don't know if everyone watching already follows me on here or if you've just come across me. If you have just come across my channel, I do a lot of printmaking, that's what I specialise in, but I also do sketching as well and do a lot of residencies. I've got 2 coming up where I go and stay somewhere and make art. So yeah, I've got 2 coming up, which is why I'm getting these prints done so they can dry while I'm away. Practice pack. It shouldn't be too long for practice pack, really, but I don't know. But yeah, if they haven't arrived in 5 to 6 weeks, you can always send him an email. He's really lovely. I think he's just written a book, hasn't he? He's just released a book, so maybe he's just like extra busy at the moment. He's in demand. I think he needs to up his prices because maybe that will help. But they're, you know, it's already quite expensive to buy blocks of wood. Because they're hardwood and, yeah, hard to come by. I make mistakes all the time. I always feel like if I'm making mistakes, at least I'm pushing myself. Like, I could just do prints that I find easy to do. But, yeah, it's nice to push yourself. Even if it ends up in with a bit of failure. I think it makes for better work. It's like less stagnant. Thank you, Emma. Yeah, when I first printed the sky, I wasn't sure because I felt like the first colour, which was a bit grey, was too different to the blue that I put on top. But now I've added the green, I think it ties it together nicely. So there we go. So thank you for watching. I would turn the camera around, but I'm not prepared for that, so thank you for watching. There'll be a new video up, I'm hoping, on Wednesday. So yeah, I will be back soon.